Hi, beautiful souls. My beautiful soul sisters. This is going to be a divine feminine reading from March the 2nd until March the 9th. So I'm going to do a Celtic wing spread with male female energies using John Holland Psychic Tarot. And then for the masculine feminine energies, I'm going to be using Dorian Virtues. Archangel guidance, and then I'm going to pull two messages from the universe using Call It Baron Reeds and my deck for clarifications. And I may use this Osho Zen Tarot for clarifications as well. I'm not too sure just yet. Whatever I feel called upon to do. Okay, so what messages do you have for the Divine Feminine from March 19th until... Or sorry, March the 2nd until the 9th. Okay, present position. Positive movement forward. The Eight of Pentacles. It is putting all of your work and effort into a project and moving forward with it. Moving towards your goal, your destiny. Yeah, so I'm going to pull a clarification card for that. The Page of Cups. You want to move forward with this new beginning of love. You want to express your love to your divine masculine. You're here with your heart chakra open, ready to give and receive love. So you want to communicate that love to him. Okay, for the foundation, shadow, the moon card. So 18 is 9. It's a completion of a cycle. It is facing your shadow aspects. So as a foundation of the reading, you have gone through a process, an unveiling, an awakening. It's, you know, seeing something clearly. Or... in the twin flame reading, you got this in your resisting position. It was with the Ace of Swords, the Ace of Pentacles, and the Divine Feminine. So there was that sense of not really seeing your path clearly. But now that it's coming in as a foundation, it seems to me like you've done your shadow work. You've stepped into your divinity, your knowing, your truth. You have clarity. So I'm going to pull a card for that. Yes. Temperance. This is harmony, balance, the integration of dualities, the come together of the yin and yang to form a singularity. This is the ultimate union card. So you are holding this balanced state between dark and light. You've done your inner work. You're grounded. This is the foundation. It is balance. Recent past position. Three of Wands. Partnership and alliances. So this is working together with someone to achieve a common goal. And it's starting to see the fruits of your labor. It's a harvest coming towards you. So in the recent past, you had a vision, a creative spark, the ignition switch to move forward with this idea that makes you feel alive. So you opened yourself up to the possibilities. You expanded your horizons, your knowing, your consciousness. And now you're waiting for the ships to come in, but you're starting to see a payoff. So this occurred in your past position. The Queen of Wands. This is someone who is very confident, charismatic. She shines her light. She is the object of desire. The masculine got this twice in his reading. So it is letting your light shine, being confident, being sexual, being the light that draws your divine towards you. But there's a sense that there's this reaching out. I'm going to pull one more card. This is going to represent the masculine energy. Ten of Wands. So he's exhausted. You know, he's tired of doing the same routine over and over again. He feels like he's taken on a lot of responsibilities. And he's ready to put some of those wands down. And it looks to me like reach out, you know, and move towards the object of his desire. So Spirit is telling you that, you know, the ships are coming in. Okay, so for the outcome that you desire and likely to get, reunion, Six of Cups, somebody from the past coming back. Sorry about that, I ran out of memory. I thought I had cleared out the memory on my phone, but I guess I didn't. Okay, so he desires a reunion as an outcome. And this is what he's likely to get. He has fond memories of the feminine. And he wants to reunite with her. He holds her gently in his hand in a loving way. He's chosen that one star in the sky. So one card for that, please. The King of Wands makes that appearance. We've got the Queen in the past position and the Queen as an outcome. So I named the Divine Masculine reading the Center of the Sun because he has come into his power. So this is the Divine Feminine outcome. It's having that reunion with the king, the object of his desires, of her desires. Sorry, I'm getting these readings mixed up. I'm so sorry. Okay, so I'm going to give it another shuffle here. So the crossroads position, please. Movement, choices, and decisions, the Two of Pentacles. This talks about having balance in a shifting world. It represents change in keeping your balance while this change is happening. It could also talk about making a decision about moving forward towards a goal. So I'm going to pull a card for that. Let me just shuffle this. The Page of Wands. So this is inspiration, a thought. It is an idea. Be excited about it and moving forward with it. And it's the messengers are communication. So it is an idea being planted in the womb. And the feminine nurturing that idea. You know, being the fuel that is turning this idea into a blaze. So the two cards together, keeping your balance. But it looks to me like there's communication that will come in the near future. So I'm going to pull one more card for that. Justice card again, balance. Karma coming back to you. And justice also talks about truth, speaking the truth. All right, so what are you resisting? Hope, the Star card. This is wish granted. It is a healing energy, comes after a period of difficulty. So I'm going to pull a card for that. Queen of Cups. You're resisting shining your light, maybe? I don't know. One more card, please, Spirit. Actually, I'm going to pull from the Osho. So then, let me just give this a quick shuffle. What message do you have for the Divine Feminine? Why is she resisting the Star card? Why is she resisting hope and the Queen of Cups, the Queen of Emotions? The Four of Swords, postponement. She fears that this will never come. And no, it's not really fear. It's what you're resisting. You're resisting seeing something. I don't know. I'm going to read this to you. So, Osho. Sorry, I want to try and keep this live so I don't have to mess about with the shuffling the cards. Okay. The woman in this picture is living in a gray landscape full of unreal cutout clouds. Through the window frame, she can see colors and light and aliveness. And although she would like to move through the frame, as we can see by the rainbow colors appearing in her garment, she can't quite manage to do that. Yeah, there's that feeling that I was picking up from the twin flame reading, that there's this, she's shining brightly like the star in the sky. She is in touch with her emotions, but there's a sense that she can't move forward with it. So, there is still too much what if activity in her mind. Tomorrow never comes, they say, but no matter how often it is said, it seems that most of us tend to forget that the truth of it. In fact, the one and only result of postponing things is dull and depressing, feeling of incompletion and stuckness today. The relief and expansiveness you will feel once you put aside all the dithering thoughts that are preventing you from acting now will make you wonder why you ever waited so long. So, you know, in the twin flame reading, I was getting that sense that she is holding back from saying, speaking her truth or moving forward with something. So yeah, that theme is kind of repeated there. All right, so her internal environment. Patience, temperance card again. Balance of her spiritual and the physical world. Being nurturing and loving, helping that seed find form. I'm going to pull one more card for that. Three of Pentacles. So starting, laying that foundation in the 3D world. So having patience. You are standing here balanced. It's that repeated theme from your foundation, balance. You've faced your shadow aspect and you're grounding this energy in the 3D world and you're being, rewarded for it. Okay, so the outcome, the external environments. Nice! Awesome. The masculine got this in his crossroads position, near future. So this is the energy that's surrounding you. It's true love. It's the twin flame connection. It's union. He's bringing union to your reading. And I read this card in the Divine Masculine. So yeah, that's beautiful. It's your twin flame is right beside you, in your environment, with you at all times. What is the outcome, please? Sacrifice, hangman, surrender, let go. Seeing things from a different perspective, letting go of control. So I'm going to pull a card for that. The Knight of Pentacles keeps showing up in this set of reading. So, yeah, that's that sure, steady, forward movement, finally arriving at that destination, something that you planned for and, It's that long journey, assured, measured steps, finally arriving at that destination. This is the best night to have because it is a solid energy. It's something that's been in the plan, in the works for a very long time. And it's coming to life. He's nearing that final step. And it's a result of this change in perspective. It's a significant change. It's a reevaluation of your life and seeing, things from a different point of view. Okay, so for the summary outcome, balance, this is a card that was that heart-centered energy for the twin flame reading. So it was a shared energy. So balance, it's the justice card again. It is karma coming back to you. It's finding peace and harmony. So I'm going to pull a card. I'm going to pull one from the Osho. Courage. Having the courage to grow, and this talks about a seed, landing on this brick wall, and the seed doesn't know that this is not the most optimal place to grow, but the seed doesn't care. It is not in that state of fear, like if I plant myself here, will I make it? There's no expectations of the future. The seed just takes root and grows. It's finding courage within. So ultimately, you will come into this balance. You got the Temperance card twice, balance. And then you got the Two Pentacles, balance, coupled with the Justice card. You are the center. You are creating this grounded energy. It's 11 again. You are the strength. Okay, so final outcome. Magician, Wizard of Awareness, card number one. Sorry, it's manifesting things into the 3D world. It's creating your own reality. Having all the tools available to you to manifest what you desire. Being connected to consciousness. So I'm going to pull a card for that. Nice. Nine of Pentacles. It's completion. It's ripeness. It's harvest. It's the fruits dropping from their branches. It's peace, harmony, relaxation. It's that final arrival again. But it's in the 3D world. It's making that moment a reality. One more card, please. Nice. The Hierophant. Again, the crown chakra activated. You will manifest the High Priest into your reality. Or at the very least, have that ethereal connection. Both crown chakras are activated. So this could be, the divine masculine really stepping into his crown chakra, which was a crowning energy for the twin flame reading. So you will ultimately manifest this ripeness, this abundance, this harvest, which has to do with an awakening, spirituality. All right, so I'm going to look at the bottom of the deck. Moving on. So Six of Swords, moving into the light. So being the light, attracting your mirror. But this talks about finally, putting those negative thoughts in the past. Moving on, taking that step forward into the sunlight. So I'm going to pull a clarification card for that, but I'm going to use the Osho deck. Morality, the Queen of Swords. Cutting out the bullshit, speaking your truth, having a truthful, honest conversation, and standing in your knowing, speaking the truth. The truth is a light. All right, so now I am going to pull the side energies here using Dorian Virtue. So the first card will be for the female external environment. Please, Spirit, what messages do you have regarding the divine masculine who is in her external environment? Three of Ariel, Three of Pentacles. Right here. So again, there's that sense of starting that foundation in the 3D. It's being recognized, illuminated. So he is working, you know, on this 3D manifestation as well. So this is your external environment for the feminine. So I'm going to pull a card for that. Moon. Got that as a foundation. So illumination, coming out of the darkness as a result of this foundation. I'm going to pull another card from the Osho Tarot. Seven of Swords. Exposing someone's false mask. Now the masculine got this as an energy, how he viewed the relationship. There's that sense of being deceived, not seeing the way clearly. One more card. Ace of Swords, speaking truth. Coming into your knowing, cutting through the darkness, letting go of this negative beliefs, this doubt, fear, you know, cutting away the dark and laying that foundation in the 3D world. Okay, for the masculine external environment, Three of Cups, reunion. It's the coming together of dualities to form love. So it says, reason to celebrate, a community of friends, happy announcements regarding relationships or children. So, yeah, I like to see this as a celebration of love. It's a feeling that that you feel inside that wakes a part of you. It makes you realize that you're connected to something much higher. It's that feeling of love, that joy, that excitement that is being celebrated. So this is his external environment, so it's energy that's coming from the feminine. So I'm going to pull a card for that. Nice, the Sun. This thought of reunion, this being surrounded by true love, unconditional love, is helping him move into the light. We got that parallel energy again. We got the Moon over on the feminine side and the Sun on the masculine side. Okay, so the feminine internal environment, the Empress, divine feminine, time to act upon your plans. Creativity is rewarded, luxurious and abundant resources. So you have stepped into your divinity. You are the creator. You are the womb of creation. You birth things into life. This indicates horizon, manifestation is on the horizon. So one more card for that, please, from the Osho. The Fool card, beginning the journey, brand new beginning, feeling free, innocent, like you can fall off that cliff and not give it a second thought. ready to take that step into the unknown. Okay, internal environment for the masculine, decisions. Release yourself from that which holds you back, a need to detox. Unnecessary worry based on lack of self-confidence. So, yeah, letting go of all those negative things that are holding you back, just a release. Internally, he's ready to let go. Go through that change. So one card, please, for that. Nice. Ace of Cups, brand new beginning. Be an open vessel to receive love. Be that channel. So internally, he's ready to let go of negativity and move on towards love. Okay, so hopes and fears for the female, Knight of Ariel. I'm not surprised. This card keeps showing up over and over and over again. Up here, it's showing up as an outcome. So surrendering, and know that return is coming towards you. One more card, nice. The Ace of Wands. Passion ignited. You were the spark that created this fiery blaze that ignited this beginning. Yeah, this is that creative spark, that aha moment. And you are the fuel by which this idea is moving forward. It's, yeah, the fuel for the fire, the drive. So this is saying that you hope for this arrival, and Spirit is saying, you know, that outcome is coming towards you. So surrender. Hopes and fears for the masculine. Five of Michael. The situation doesn't serve you. Release your attachment to the outcome. Consider taking a more uplifting approach. So the feminine got this in her external environment for the twin flame reading. So this is conflict and defeat. It is walking away from negativity. It's, you know, somebody's pointing the finger at you, and, you know, you're walking away from it. You're not having it anymore. So I'm going to pull a card from the Osho Zen. Nice. Two of Cups. Seeing yourself in another. Hoping for this spiritual union. You know, but there's that sense of pointing the finger still. You hope to move beyond this mental conflict. Release it and accept love into your heart. Okay, so final outcome from the feminine. Queen of Cups. Yeah, baby. So there's a sense that you're resisting, letting your light shine, seeing the bright side, but at the same time being that grounded, loving source of light. So hold on to hope. So yeah, the Queen of Raphael, kind, understanding, giving, psychic. Follow your heart, a love of home and family, trustworthy psychic information. So this card is saying that trust the psychic information that's being given to you. Hint, hint. So yeah. Your final outcome is to feel this abundance of love. You will become the Queen of Cups. I'm going to pull a card for that. So Four of Cups. Four of Cups talks about longing, stagnation, things not moving fast enough. So it's like that wait is over. So here we have, you know, down here, looking out the window and not seeing how you are not imprisoned by the mind, you know, and seeing that light. But then over here, we got that repeated looking out the window and longing. So I get the sense that that longing, that wanting, that waiting is nearing completion. Okay, so final come from the masculine, the high priestess. Powerful psychic insights. Oh my God, it's a mirror. Reflection and meditation that provides valuable information, be at peace. High priestess. So, as your outcome, you got the Wizard of Awareness, which is the magician with the high priest. So his destiny is the high priestess. But it's also stepping into that internal knowing, your intuition, allowing that to guide you. So one card for that, please. Six of Swords again. So you guys, the feminine got this as an overall energy. It's, you know, stepping from the darkness into the light, towards truth, towards, you know, moving from choppy waters to calmer waters, finally leaving a difficult situation. Okay, so now I'm going to pull two cards from Call It Baron Reed, and I will read those to you. Sorry about all the noise. There's kids playing outside my window. Oh, nice. Commitment card. Awesome. So this means that that a commitment of some form is surrounding you. Beautiful. So I'm going to read that, but that's kind of, I guess, an overall energy. So for the feminine, please. Magic stream, being the vessel, the channel for that ethereal light, being connected to consciousness. And for the masculine, okay. Unexpected visitors in reverse. So this is like the Wheel of Fortune card. All right, so let me read those to you. So number 36, commitment. A true commitment is a responsibility of the heart, mind, and body and soul. This is a good time to make one. Partnerships formed at this time are harmonious and powerful. The commitment card indicates the natural evolution of a relationship from its inception to a literal or metaphorical marriage. At the very least, there is a promise of fulfillment in some form. However, you must be conscious of what you're committing to. Be clear about the nature of your commitment and your responsibility to it. Others are more willing to enter into partnerships at this time. Remember that your partnership with spirit and the highest version of your own self will engage the highest self in another. Yes, that is so true. Okay, so number 18, magic stream. Okay, magic stream. Everything is connected through the universal flow of consciousness. Every experience you have seems to have its own life story with a beginning, middle, and eventually an end. However, there is a danger in seeing events as separate from one another, since in fact they are all part of a continuity and a great evolution. Like an ever-flowing magic stream, your experiences filter through the whole world, one leading into another, informing and influencing still more. Inspiration, invention, and revelations are rarely come to just one person. The collective awareness is a shared storehouse of potential. When you remember you're part of a fluid continuity of life, you become a channel for great inspiration. Allow the magic to flow through you and carry your dreams into reality. Your success will benefit many. Yes. The magician. And number 41. So, unexpected visitor in reverse. Unpleasant news is only unpleasant when you resist accepting what is. Sometimes the things most desired is kept away from you because it's not for your highest good of you or others. Sometimes there is a loss or disappointment due to a destiny whose pattern can't be understood yet. Change is something that may be forced upon you, like bad weather that threatens a boat. Adapt to the shift in conditions and think how beautiful the sky will be afterward. Accept what is, and a more fulfilling path will soon be revealed. Remember that if you expect the unexpected, nothing can come as a shock. So, yeah, there's a sense that a tower is coming. If you're not ready to move forward, then it will happen for you. So, yeah, I love this. Stay open. Be that vessel, because he's going to be going through something very difficult, which ultimately, you know, is leading to union. Okay, I hope this helped you guys. Cheers and much love.